I'm frequently asked, how do I know that my project idea is going to be a good fit for Six Sigma methodology? Now, I have four questions that I usually ask my students or my green belts to help them identify if a project is a good fit for Six Sigma. The first question I ask is this a new process and/or does it require significant capital? If you're talking about purchasing a bunch of modems for an entire building or a bunch of new vehicles for your entire fleet of cars, then I'm probably going to send you in the direction of a project manager. A project manager is probably going to have more of the skills and resources to implement those really big projects and manage that capital, more so than a Six Sigma leader. Now, the next question that I'm going to ask you is a solution known? If you already know the solution, you don't need a big Six Sigma project because the Six Sigma project may not identify the solution that you've identified or a solution that's already started to move forward. So if you already know, if you're already committed to a solution, then just go do it. Keep pursuing that. You don't need a big Six Sigma project to validate or invalidate that solution. My third question. Is data on the problem hard to find? If you can't find data on this problem that you want to work on, then go ahead and put things in place now so that you can go start collecting that data, right? So put some things in place now so that you can get data, collect that data over time, and hopefully in the next few weeks or months, you'll start to see that information come in. So then you can say yes to that question and be ready to move forward with that as a Six Sigma project. Now, my final question that I ask is, can this be completed in 3 to 4 months? So we're not going to eat the whole elephant. We're not going to boil the ocean. We're going to take projects in 3 to 4 month chunks. So if you're looking at a bunch of Six Sigma ideas for projects, take any of those that are going to take more than 3 to 4 months and break them down. See if you can break them into 2 or 3 different projects to work on. And then you can start ranking those. Now, if your projects pass those 4 questions, the next thing I would go ahead and do is rank those by impact and effort. Which of your project ideas is going to be the easiest to implement and going to have the biggest impact to your organization? If you do these, if you go through these questions and then rank by impact and effort, you're going to have a wonderful queue of projects for your Six Sigma teams to start executing.